He knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
Okay, today we're going to try some dilution problems. So the first one says 0.850 liters of a 5.00 molar solution of sodium chloride is diluted to a volume of 1.80 liters with water. What is the concentration of the diluted solution? The next one asks, what volume of 0.12 molar HCl can be prepared from 11 milliliters of a stock solution of 0.45 molar HCl? And the third one asks, what volume of 1.59 molar NaOH is required to prepare a 5.00 liter solution of 0.1 molar NaOH? So if this seems confusing, go ahead and check out my tutorial on solutions and dilution. It goes through these calculations. It'll give you the information you need. And when you're ready, give this a try. So let's take a look at this first question. Now, for all of these questions, anytime we're doing dilution, we're always going to use this equation, M1V1 equals M2V2. That means the concentration or molarity of the initial solution times the volume of the initial solution will be equal to the concentration or molarity of the final solution times the volume of the final solution. So this is very easy to do. We're just going to plug in what we know and solve for what we don't. So in this particular case, what is it that we're trying to get? Well, we are asked, what is the concentration of the diluted solution? So we had some solution, some initial solution, and then we diluted it to get a different solution, and we want to know the concentration of that diluted solution. So we want M2. That's what we're going for. So let's solve for M2 just to make this easy on ourselves. If we divide both sides by V2, we're going to get M2 equals M1V1 over V2. Now we just plug in what we know. So M1, or the concentration of the initial solution, is 5 molar. So that's our stock solution of sodium chloride. We had 5 molar sodium chloride. That's M1. V1 is 0.850 liters. That's the initial volume. That's the volume of that stock solution we used. Then we diluted it. So when we diluted it to V2. We diluted it to 1.80 liters with water. That's the final volume, or V2. So then we just put these in a calculator, and what do we get? 2.36 molar. So this was diluted, which means our answer must be of a lower concentration than the initial concentration. So if you want to double check and see that it makes sense, we had a more concentrated solution. We ended up with a diluted solution. It should be a smaller concentration. And here that is the case. So this checks out. That makes sense. Now moving on to the second one. Once again, we are going to use M1V1 equals M2V2. So what is it that we're trying to solve for? Well, it's asking what volume of a particular concentration solution of HCl can be prepared from a stock solution. So we are given information about a stock solution, and we want to know what volume of a diluted solution we can prepare. So that's V2. We want to solve for V2. So let's just divide both sides by M2, and we're going to get V2 equals M1V1 over M2. And now, once again, we just plug in what we know. So V2 is going to be equal to M1. So it says that the stock solution was 0.45 molar. So that is our initial concentration. And V1 is 11 milliliters because we used 11 milliliters of that stock solution. So that's M1 and V1. And then we divide by M2. That's the concentration of the desired diluted solution. So we're trying to get a 0.12 molar solution. We started with 0.45, and our final diluted solution needs to be 0.12 molar. And so what volume is our diluted solution going to be? We plug those numbers in, and we get 41 milliliters. And the diluted solution needs to have a volume that is greater than the stock solution, right? Because we're adding water to it. So we want to check and make sure that's larger than the stock solution. So we had 11 milliliters. Now we have 41 milliliters. That is a greater volume. So that checks out. And that's going to be V2 for this problem. Now let's take a look at number 3. Once again, we're going to use M1V1 equals M2V2. So what are we solving for this time? Well, it asks what volume of a particular stock solution is required to prepare a diluted solution with those values. So we're solving for V1 this time. We want to know what volume of the stock solution we need to dilute to get to what we want. So let's solve for V1. We just divide both sides by M1, and we get V1 equals M2V2 over M1. So let's plug some things in. V1 is going to be equal to 0.100 molar. That is the M2. That is the concentration of the desired diluted solution. So we're trying to make a solution that is 0.1 molar, and so that's M2. V2 is the volume associated with that diluted solution. So that solution that we're trying to get, that's 0.1 molar, we need 5 liters of it. We want 5 liters of a 0.1 molar solution. So 0.1 times 5, that's our M2 and V2. And then dividing by M1, that is going to be 1.59 molar. That is the concentration of the stock solution. So now we're trying to find V1, which is the volume of the stock solution we need. And if we do the arithmetic, we are going to get 0.314 liters. So we are diluting the stock solution quite a bit. So we want to make sure that the volume of the stock solution is much, much smaller than the volume of the resulting diluted solution, right? That diluted solution is 5 liters, and we're taking just a little bit of the stock solution, 0.314 liters of it, and diluting it up to 5 liters with water. So that checks out, and that's the answer for this question.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, support me on Patreon so I can keep making content, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.